Varsop. This is Blaise the Movie Fan, and I have many times before made spoiler-free movie reviews where I review a movie completely at random. But this marks the first time I'm doing it on a spoiler movie review. The movie I'm reviewing now is Skater from 1976. I know literally nothing about it. Is it a good movie? Is it a bad movie? Well, only one way to find out. So without further ado, let's dive in. The movie starts at court, and I'm gonna have to be honest, I find that court scene to be very fucking boring. At the top of that, I am very fucking confused on what the hell the guy is even talking about. But at the plus side, when New York City is brought up, at least that part of the court scene is interesting. Now thankfully, as soon as the court scene is over, the movie does get good. This movie has opening credits, and I have to admit, the opening credits are beyond fucking awesome. Anyway, we are introduced to a character who looks like a grumpy old man. I am saying looks like because he is not really. You will know what I mean soon enough.
You know, you hang around with murderers and thieves and crooks and Lord knows what else.
All right, I will admit that is pretty messed up.
This child's been out of school too long. 2 years. She's beginning to revert to the wilds.
He is absolutely right. Girls at her age really need to be in fucking school. People need school in order to be in good jobs in society. Without school, it's very hard to find a good job.
I'll tell you what else she needs. She needs to hang around youngins her own age instead of an old codger like me.
Okay, that is another good point. A kid needs to spend time with other children. That is the best way a kid can have fun. Now remember earlier on in the video when I said that he looked like a grumpy old man, but later on in the movie it turns out that he isn't. This is what I was talking about. At first he looks like a grumpy old man. But you know what? He makes legitimate points, and grumpy old men wouldn't make legitimate points. That's what I was talking about. Anyway, there is something that we get to learn about Gator. Apparently he is a criminal that is wanted by the police force. And wow, he must be fucking off somewhat being a criminal if the police is after him.
I said turn the boat toward the goddamn marker!
Wait a minute, did he just say gosh damn? He might have said that because of censorship issues, but no, that's not the case. The word shit is clearly said later on in the movie. So if shit is allowed to be said in the movie, I'm sure that gosh damn is also allowed to be said in the movie. So there is absolutely no reason for there to be gosh damn here. In fact, it sounds fucking stupid. Gosh damn would be a much better word here. Anyway, there's a very fun boat chasing where the cops are after a guy in a speedboat. And I gotta say, I fucking love every minute of that scene. The cops can't touch that guy and that's beyond fucking awesome. Anyway, some of the cops get to the old man and he punches them into the water. And I have to say, that is beyond fucking awesome. And then Gator surrenders. Come on, I think he's surrendering far too easily. But he surprises me, apparently he was tricking them and now kicks their ass. I have to say, that is beyond fucking awesome. Anyway, Gator's speedboat goes over the fucking bridge and I gotta say, that's beyond fucking awesome.
Gator McCluskey, you're under arrest!
No offense, but would it make more sense to say this after you fucking caught him? The next day, Gator starts driving someone. Hold on a minute, the police was after him the last day. Is the movie seriously just gonna ignore that and then move on? Well, okay then. I mean seriously, why wouldn't the cops still be after him the next day? It makes no damn sense.
I don't drive. You don't drive?
No, I don't drive. When you're from New York, you don't drive.
Well, that makes sense.
Wow, this is a huge generalization and it's wrong. I've been to New York City many times before and the roads are always crowded. So obviously there are a lot of people in New York that do drive. And if this is supposed to be a joke, it isn't funny. Anyway, in the next scene, there's a random woman in the background swinging. I'm sorry, but I find that very distracting and it isn't even funny. And then comes a scene with a beat up at a bar. And surprisingly, I don't have a lot to say about it. That's something that applies to more scenes in the movie, honestly. I have very little to say about most of the scenes in the movie. I guess that has to do with the fact that I've only seen this movie once. Whereas with most of my spoiler movie reviews, I do a spoiler review on a movie that I've seen many times. I guess having little to nothing to say happens when I review a movie totally at random. But you know what? I might review a movie at random again with a spoiler movie review. Because it still is fun to do a spoiler movie review on a movie that I know almost nothing about. And then there is a scene of a cop that's too busy eating. I have to admit, that is fucking funny. And then we cut back to Gator and the guy he is driving. And also, I'm sorry to say, but for this review, I don't feel like looking up the name of the characters. Normally, I do, but this time, I don't feel like doing it. Anyway, those two have very interesting conversations. And I like that. And then there's a fucking parade. I'm gonna admit, that's pretty cool. And then Gator has a conversation with someone. And there are apparently people monitoring everything. Now, let me make something perfectly clear. Even though I don't have a lot to say about this movie, I don't think this movie is bad, far from it. And I don't even think it's a decent movie. I really like most of the characters, and I do think that the movie is, for the most part, fucking awesome. I'm just having a very hard time thinking of a lot of things to say. Anyway, there is one scene in the movie that I don't like. And that's when somebody is saying some very racist things. Basically, he's driving Gator and he's saying some very racist things about black people. Yeah, that honestly offends me. Not by a whole lot, mind you, but it offends me a little bit. Anyway, Bama shoots a jukebox for some reason. Yeah, I don't know why the hell he does that. Not only that, he also shoots the fuck out of a car. That is very fucking insane, and I like it. Anyway, at someone else's house, Gator has sex with a slut. Hold on a minute, isn't he already married? Anyway, at the bar, someone is apparently poisoning a drink for Gator. That is fucking disgusting. Why the hell would anybody do that? For most of the movie, he has been very nice. Anyway, Gator wakes up finding himself in the middle of fucking nowhere. Wow, that sucks. Anyway, Greenfield gets hurt massively and is now at a hospital. And I have to say, it really sucks for him that he is hurt so badly. I hope he will recover soon. Speaking of insane, there is also a scene where Gator drives the car while having a fucking guy in the window. That is very fucking insane and I like it. Anyway, later in the movie, Gator robs a bank with help from two women, one of which is very obsessed with her cat. I gotta say, the fact that she's obsessed with her cat is very fucking funny. Anyway, Greenfield tries to get out of the hospital even though he's clearly still injured. Are you sure that's just a good idea? I mean, you can't get even fucking worse from this. And he also takes the thing on his neck off. Again, I don't think this is a good idea. And then Gator has a conversation with a woman. Again, I must ask, isn't this guy married already? The reason why I think he's already married is because he has a fucking daughter near the beginning of the movie. So he must be already married. Anyway, Gator wants to use a phone booth, but unfortunately, it's already in use. And he isn't waiting patiently until he can use it. Look, Gator, I understand that you have an important call, but you have to fucking wait patiently. Other people would need to use the phone booth as well. I mean, seriously. Anyway, some sick bastard threatens Greenfield with a gun and even burns the fucking house while he is still in it. Wow, what a sick bastard. Poor Greenfield, he doesn't deserve any of this at all. Now, there's something regarding this movie that I want to talk about. It has nothing to do with the story or the characters, but it's still something that I want to discuss. Back in the 1970s, there were phones in the cars. And I have to say, that's beyond fucking awesome. Now this is of course long before cell phones became common. But the wired phones in cars were still very fucking interesting back then. And to be honest, I think phones like that even existed in the 1990s. Because I vaguely remember a phone like that from my childhood. This is something interesting to point out. Moving on. And the gator starts making some traps at the motel in preparation for some enemies that are coming. That's beyond fucking Amazon, but the question is, do the traps work? Holy shit, the trap works remarkably well. I absolutely fucking love how the enemy is just blown away. Anyway, Gator beats the shit out of someone in a hand-to-hand combat. And I gotta say, that is beyond fucking awesome. Now it's time for my overall thoughts. Honestly, Gator is a fucking awesome movie. Though there isn't a lot I could say about it. It might have to do with the fact that I was watching it for the very first time. Whereas with most of my spoiler movie reviews, I do a spoiler movie review of a movie that I have seen many times before. Hopefully next time I pick a movie totally at random to do a spoiler movie review with, I will have more to say about it. But I'm still glad I saw this movie because it is fucking awesome. It has great characters, the story was very interesting, and yeah, this movie is honestly fucking awesome to me. And for that, I'm of course going to give it the rating 2 thumbs up. Let's hope the next movie I do a spoiler movie review of when I pick Hilder at random will be as good as this one. Or hopefully with more for me to say. Well guys, here is the end of the video. Thank you for watching and have a great day.